ambassador in Berlin handed the German government a final note, stating that unless we heard from them by 11 o'clock, that they were prepared at once to withdraw their troops from Poland, a state of war would exist between us. I have to tell you now that no such undertaking had been received, and that consequently this country is at war with Germany.
Of course, being our lovely audience here this afternoon. If you just bear with me 1 second, I just have to contact the girls and guys that run the show. Just a minute. Let's see what's happening. Hello? Hello, Ginger? Oh, hello, how are you? Yes, good. Oh, yes, fine looking bunch, yes. What? Really? Ginger's just asked, for sound level purposes, before we go live, could he have, after three, a light ripple of applause, please? Here we go. One, two, three. Oh, he likes that very much. Yes, that was good. Well, yes, yes, what? Oh, well, if you must, yes, yes. Is it possible also we could just try a small cheer after three for sound levels? Here we go. One, two, three. Oh, yes, he likes that. Yes, yes. Oh, well, we'll try. Apparently, gentlemen, brace yourselves. We're going to try and do two things at once now. Yes, we're going to cheer and clap at the same time. Oh, what's that? Oh, we're going to do it as well as though we've won the war. You ready? After three. One, two, three. Oh, he likes that very much. What's that? One more, but a little more volume at the back. Yes, at the back. He did not quite get to the people at the back here. One, two, three. Oh, very good. Yes, what's that? Oh, oh, ladies and gentlemen, please enjoy the show. We're about to go live to the rest of the nation in three, two, one.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen.
Bless them all, beautiful stage, live from entertaining our forces abroad, the one, the only, forces sweetheart herself, Miss Vera Lynn. There you go, Miss Lynn. Do take care.
The night we met, there was magic abroad in the air. There were angels dining at the Ritz, and a nightingale sang in Berkeley Square. I may be wrong, I may be right, but I'm
afternoon. Yes, I'm afraid he's locked in to negotiations at the moment and won't be able to join us. So I do hope you don't mind, I'd like to share a little bit of culture with you. I'm currently working on a new one-man show, and, I'm taking a classic by Charles Dickens, Oliver Twist, and I'm going to play all the parts. I am. From Nancy herself, right through to Bullseye the dog. Now, in this excerpt I'm going to give you here, Bill Sykes, the Honourable Bill Sykes, has found out that Nancy has shopped him to the Rossers. So stand by, here we go. Nancy, Nancy, where are you, Nancy?
Who are you calling a Nancy, eh? Hang on, you're going to have to do better than that one time on today. All together or not at all? All right, we'll try it. Do it again, kids.
Nancy, Nancy, where are you, Nancy?
Who are you calling a Nancy, eh?
It's a nice looking crowd, isn't
very
it,
nice.
Chitler? Look at her down the front. I like the look of that. Well, let's come and have a look. You all right, my darling, coming down?
You're looking at the coat, aren't you? You like the coat, don't you, Mrs. Hayley? Do you like it, ladies and gents? Do you like it? Well, never feel that one. Do be careful, sweetheart. Someone's got to sit on that seat after you.
Yes,
I bought this coat backing a horse, you know, isn't it? I'll bet they threw the window at Woolworths. You should try it sometime. Now, never.
A long way out today, you know, might get a nosebleed.
Do steps.
I hope that sweat. Oh, now listen, Chess. Chess.
Yes.
I don't suppose.
Yes.
I shouldn't be laughing, I haven't got a ticket. Listen, I don't suppose you know what's going on, do you? I just woke up in the dressing room and somebody, mentioning no names, had locked the door from the outside.
Oh.
Ain't that sad? You wouldn't know anything about that, would you, Chess?
No. It wasn't me, no.
You're not trying to get rid of me, are you, Chesney?
No.
Come on, I paid for free over there.
No, of course not, Bud. What? Why?
Well, I just don't want you to go on your own. I wouldn't be anything without you, Chesney. They've got it there, haven't they?
Don't know.
Well, listen, Chesney, won't you answer me this, friend? We've been friends for a long time.
A long time, of course we have, Bud.
If we went our separate ways,
I can't go back to it all day, honestly.
If we went our separate ways, would you remember me a year from now, Chess?
Of course I would, Bud.
Oh, isn't that nice? That's lovely. Would you remember me 5 years from now, Chess?
Of course I would, Bud.
Oh, I feel a lot better. I really do this. But would you remember me then? This is the test. Would you remember me 50 years from this date?
Of course I would, oh pal.
Oh, do you know, I'll sleep easy in my bed tonight, Mrs.
Yes.
I really will. Here, Chess.
Yes?
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
You see, he's forgotten me already. Where would we be without a laugh, eh? Agbrick. Now listen.
This is better.
What were you doing?
I'll share a little bit of culture with the ladies and gentlemen here today.
Culture with this house? You've read this crowd all wrong, haven't you? No. I tell you what they like. Do you all like a bit of community singing, ladies and gentlemen? Yeah? They like a bit of community singing.
Yeah.
Right, go on then. Tell them what we're going to sing, Chess.
Oh, my bonnie lies over the ocean.
Underneath. Oh, what?
My bonnie lies over the ocean.
My bonnie lies over. I wasn't expecting that. Do you all know it, ladies and gentlemen? My bonnie lies over the ocean.
Yes, they do.
Yeah, well, I'll tell you what we'll do then.
Right.
To make it a bit more interesting, ladies and gents, while we